Queen even introduces her, I'm just gonna walk and put it in front of her. And, because she's wanting to go that way, I just turn and say, "Oh, me," and I'm just gonna move this thing around in front of her without coming at her. Mm-hmm. And then she'll get used to it more in a non-threatening way. She'll get used to that it's gonna move and then it's not really gonna mean anything. So this is taking it sort of like if they were afraid of a car, instead of running the car up at them, let the car move and have the horse follow it, you know. And let them just follow it and send it like it's going away, but then not at them. So you can see I'll get her pretty comfortable with this before I even do anything with it with her. But if you see her licking and chewing, which I think is a good thing, that's the start of the home. And, you know, she's been in the stall all night too, so she's should have extra energy in her anyway. Just for, but you see, she's gone. Yeah, did you notice the change already? Her change happened pretty quick. She chilled pretty bad, you know, right? And that's kind of stuff you have to look for. Looking for when I'm working with a horse, especially if, you know, people having issues with it, is that the horse gets stressed out and the human doesn't really notice what that looks like. And if we don't know what it looks like, then we just keep, you know, we might add more questions and pile on, and then we're overflowing the cup, you know. And so you have to learn to recognize what is stress like, a little bit of it. What does it look like when you relax? Because you're literally playing the game of trying to get them to do, you know, if they're looking tense, can you do some things and help them relax and change up and down, whatever it is you have to do. And so you've got a little bit of a sign. And so that's what I'm looking for, is that her stress level goes down. That means she's more quiet, more calm. She's not feeling threatened, because if she's feeling threatened, everything is going to feel like that. And so, yeah. See how I'm turning and she's following it? That's better than the other way, avoiding it. Because like she's being curious. You see, I'm like going like this, and she's going and following it. Like, even though he was scared of some things, like the tarp, then when I put it down, he's like, "But I need to go look at it."
Yeah.
And that's good. You want them to be curious. If they're totally avoidant of things, they're like, "It's all going to kill me." And they're going to be like, "I don't want to go there. I don't want to do this." And they actually disappear in their head. And that's not good, because then they're like avoiding it, like that's not even there, and then they lose their crap. So we want them to be like curious. And when they are curious, we don't want to knock that curiosity out of them. If you do, you put the opposite of curiosity in fear. So if I can get her to be curious of something, we're heading out of fear and into being interested and feeling brave enough to go check it out. And then I just have to prove you on that it's safe. And then they go, "Oh, we're over here." Now I'm just feeling a little bit of motion up here where I don't think it's threatening, but I'm watching her. If I feel like I go too far, or I'm looking to see, I don't want to go over her threshold of what she can handle. And I do something for a little bit, and then I quit. There's like I'm a two. So that's soak time. I'm like, even though this is supposed to be the friendly game, it is. She doesn't know that yet. I'm like, "That damn thing wiggling around, I don't know what that is." So I have to do even things that are meant to be soothing to her. I have to know that they're not at first. So I have to do it and get the right response and take it away when I have the right response and give her a full break. So she's like, "Thank you." And it go all the way away. And then one day she will like, "Oh no, this is a break." Okay? And she'll be like, "Oh, they're putting that flag on me. Yay, it's done. Right? But you see, she's definitely, she's chained in and she's letting me go a little further. But I always approach and retreat it. I wouldn't just go, "Okay, she's doing good. I'll do more. That's, you know, even if they're accepting it, you might still be just like raising, you know, filling the cup too high.
Mm-hmm.
And they're handling it, but you're still just pouring the cup up. And then they can handle it and they start walking around. And what do people do then? They quit that.
Yeah.
That's a big one. You have to make sure that you take the stimulus away on the thing you want them to do, which is think okay or stand. Like right now, if she's standing still, I don't really want to make her move. I don't want this to make her move unless I intend for it to. This is the friendly game right now, and I'm supposed to be just soothing her with it. So if I make her move, that means I went over her threshold. She felt like, "Oh, that don't feel good." So I want to make sure if I do that, then I would have to keep doing this until I got her to stop again, even if her mind didn't. And I go, "Bingo, I'll take it away, when you stop." And I just have to keep repeating that, even if her mind doesn't understand it. because like pretty soon her mind will go, wait a minute. Like then they start, after you do it too many times, then they start catching on, the brain does. Oh, you want to stay with it a little bit now, huh? See how she's starting to be like, you don't want to mess with it. And so now, like, Sandy's side is looking at you, so we're seeing all the body language. She is looking around and gets distracted a little bit, but I'm not going to be, she's not moving right now. I technically want their attention span on me. Like I'm greedy as hell with that. Because I don't want them to be like, but I got to watch over there and see about over here and this and that. I want her, every horse that I play with and work with, I want to act like I'm going to tell them that I'm going to put this little stall around them. That's like a rectangle, the shape of them. It's not a square. And it's see-through. She can't see it. Nobody can see it. But it's like home for us, right? It's like you go home and you should be able to get away from the stress. That's where you feel the safest, right? So I try to teach my horses, I got you. I got the home wrapped around you. You don't have to worry about it. I will do all that. I'll take care of it. You just be like, Lori's got me. You know, it's like my kid should be like, I don't have to worry about life. My mom's got me. If I'm by myself, I might freak out, right? So I want them to be like, I don't even have to because she got me, okay? So, and so now if I decide I'm gonna start maybe petting her down her neck or something, so I start and I go like this, and then I start and I slide down her neck and then come off of it like that. Alright. So I'll go where she's already okay with it, and I'm gonna slide a little bit off of her neck and then leave again. Alright? And then lift into it. Slide, and I just don't stay there long. And then I just keep doing it very, very consistently. I don't just then one day come go fast, you know. I'm trying to be very predictable at this point. Not unpredictable. She's not ready for that yet. Predictability is very important right now. You see how she's like, I'm not minding. So she's giving me, that's the other thing I say, well, what is she giving you? And yes, answers are knowing, right? She's saying, I'm fine. So if she keeps giving me yeses, I then go, I can go a little further that because she said fine. If she starts saying no, then I know that I have to stop there and get that. I have to be okay with that amount or whatever at that moment. That she can't handle me going further. So there's a lot of yes. Good job. And as you move further back, or as you go down the legs, again, those are the most protected parts, is their legs. And then as you go back forward, that's their engine. So that's pretty important. And you go tiny feet. And if you, I always tell my people, I'm actually painting the walls of this arena. And I have got all these cool things that I'm going to paint on the walls. It's going to be like a big, huge classroom, you know, sort of like picture, like college board where everything's written on these notes. Oh, that's what's going to be on here because I have so many cool things that, like, I hate repeating all the time. I'm like, why don't we just have a little artwork this day, yeah, you know? And, but so, like, the big thing is, like, there's zones of your horse. And we have zone one is from her halter forward. Everything in her halter is called the delicate zone, so we don't try to mess with that. But anything from her nose band this way is zone one, and then this from here to here is two. And then from here to here, her shoulder and her belly is three. And then her flank to the end where her tail starts, it's four. And then five is her tail. And yeah. So if you actually think about them as five different horses, like that's why I'm like, I have to make sure this one is okay with it before I then go to this one, right? Before I then go to this one. Because I started up here, and that doesn't mean that Tom the tail back there is okay with it because spread the face is, right? And that's when people are wrong. They're like, well, I did it up here. Well, I did. Why did you kick me back there? Because that's a totally different body part. And you didn't, you just went there, and that's way far away, right? So if you think about that, that's why I'm like, think of, don't, it's not one horse. It is five different parts, and then you got five different parts on the other side, and then you got the front and the back. So you have actually like 12 places, and then maybe even more because you can go under, and that would under all those parts and all those spots, right? And then over on all those spots. So picture that's five and five, five and five. That's 20. So it's in the front, and you know, and up all the way up and down. So you got like 30 spots. But you have to get okay with all this stuff, right? Good job. Okay, let's play a little bit. Now I'm gonna put some pressure on it. And I'm just doing something, I'm making it slightly uncomfortable, just enough. Now just increase it a little bit. Right there is all I wanted. Just the tiniest amount. And I go, that's all I want. I just want you to do a tiny try. And then I'll take and dump all that pressure off. And she's like, But you see now she's pretty chill, no licking and chewing. That's how fast her brain switched back to, I'm okay, that's the left brain. That shows what I'm thinking. She's very a left brain horse. She goes, faster than stop like that other horse is not one. You're just making a commotion over here. That's now it's motion that's not supposed to feel comfortable. It's supposed to be uncomfortable. But I'm not trying to make it too uncomfortable. Just the right amount. It's like, I always say like the little children's book with the three bears. It's too hot or it's too cold. I need to make it just right, you know? So I'm like, no, I'm trying to get just the right amount. Starting at very little and then only going up to the amount that is just the right amount that just gets her to try a little bit. But if I did it too much, she'd just what? Blow, yeah. Right? Or if I don't do it enough, she doesn't move at all. Or she runs into you, okay? So that's how that works. So now I'm gonna go again, I'm gonna go, make this uncomfortable. I'm just gonna slow, it's like a tornado. I'm gonna make it a little bigger. I'm just gonna move for Joe a little at a time to get time to think about it. And there's that step left. And now if she'd have kept going backwards, I would have kept going. That's not the kind of step I needed. I need to turn her shoulder left. And I would have just hung with her until she got it, and then nothing again. Alright? Yeah, you're a nice horse. Karen got a nice horse. Okay, here we go again. So uncomfortable motion. See, I'm putting it back here, and I'm giving her lots of time to decide to move before it's there. Like, I'm making it, like, it's up to you. It's your choice. You can stand still, or you can move before it gets there. And that's the goal. I want her to be like, oh, wait, that's a suggestion to go now. Like I say, I use the tornado a lot. I'm like, okay, so what if we, throw a tornado drop out there? And you see little baby tornadoes, though, right? And you see these little dust things. And, oh, look at that cute little tornado out there. And we all think it's cute. And now if that tiny little tornado starts moving towards you, we'd all laugh. We're like, this is going to be fun. Let's stand in the tornado. It's tiny. But if you saw it dropping out of the tiny, and then it starts growing and getting, it's not moving. The sucker gets bigger and bigger and bigger. As it gets bigger, we know that's not good, right? So it goes from tiny, I would say, just picture a tornado, it's born, it lands, it's tiny, and it has to get massive before it moves, okay? So that's what we do here. I want you to go make it little somewhere, grow it there, then move it. Don't move it when it's little, okay? Yet, we're not there yet, okay? Because you don't want, what I don't want to do is be like, little, because I see people do this all the time, and they're like, right up here, and they're like, and then I'm like, and then you can put the kibosh down and she can nail you.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
They get too close.
Yeah.
So the point is, you're trying to be like, hey, if there's a tornado growing there, and then if we found out that, it's coming our way. I'm a loudspeaker in Goodfield. There's a tornado in Goodfield. We'd all go, where is it going? If it's going to Peoria, we'd all be like, let's go to the window and watch, right? We wouldn't care because it's not coming into our face. If we find out it's headed our way, we're an idiot if we stand here, right? If we can move, you move before it gets there. So that's why I'm going, hey, there's a tornado over here. Can you notice that it's coming your direction? And I'm going to promise that if tornadoes don't have feelings, they're going to run into this barn if it's coming this way. So that's the other thing. If those humans, they go, oh, I don't want to hit my horse, and they stop right here. Tornadoes don't go like this and go around houses. They go through them, right? So that's why you have to warn, and you have to give all the warnings here, and you have to go, I promise, I'm going to go through here. And if you're still there, it's going to run into you, and you're not going to like it, and you're going to move, bingo, and then I'll pet you again with it, and it'll feel like a nice breeze again. So those are the two different ways. So now I'm going to do the same thing with her hind feet. Never had it done. Now I'm going to act like there's an X on the side of her tail, on the side of her tail, and I'm going to go, like, I'm going to come out this way so I can put pressure straight that way to make her butt go that way, okay? So I've got a little tornado, and as soon as it's right there, I've got a hind foot, bingo, that's all I got to do. I don't have to go and ask for 500 steps because she's totally chill. I'm just trying to get this the slightest try, and then let's hang out again and do nothing. And just be like, ah. All right, ready for another one? So I'm going to go, hey, that spot on your tail, I want it to move. There, you did it. You're so smart. It's like an old pro. But, people can come up and just start doing and asking for a lot of stuff, and they can just blow this horse up because they're asking too much. You are a question.
Yep.
So now I'm going to ask her front feet again. So again, I'm going to go, and I act like, when I do their front feet, just act like I put a big X, like on her neck. Okay, and that's the goal. So, there's the tornado went that way. Okay, so now I can go, all right, so, yep, tornado is coming. towards the side of your neck. Now she doesn't move, I'm gonna let it bump into her, just the cloth. And then she still was like, I don't care about cloth, and I have to tap her with that thing, so. And then as soon as I do that though, then go back to going, it's not always uncomfortable, it's mostly gonna be comforting to you, play the fun with you. You are so good. This is just like your arm. You can't be like, oh, my left arm hits her, my right arm does her. No, you can't. They have to, or whatever, you know, moves her. And it's not a hit. A hit is like, I'm just trying to punish something. The cold point is that you have to move the feet, you know. That's how horses decide who the alpha is. Who can make the other one move, okay? So I'm saying, I want you to move out of that space because I want to own it. And I made her move away from it. So I own that spot.
You're a good alpha,
okay? But if she can make me move, if she can take over my real estate, then she did, okay? What you doing, honey?
She's coming in here to say, I need some water.
I need some water. Myself.
Good girl. Aw, you are so smart. You are so smart.
There you are. So now I might introduce and go, okay, now let's turn. Give us a sort of idea of a turn. You said it's just motion and loud noise, and it's just a tap and a flag. I'm gonna go down my point and go, hey, you can turn and you can keep moving. So let me point my hand, said turn and I will allow you to keep moving. Okay? And you can go. She went for a little bit and was like, what am I doing? I'm like, that's fine. You can stop and check in again. And then and say, thank you for that tiny bit of forward motion. Now I'm gonna go, hey, why don't you go and turn again that way and you can go. And so she's like, is that right?
Yes, that's right.
Check in. See if you did it right. That's it. Now tornado in front of you. What are you doing? Nope, from there. So turn that way. Tornado. So every time I get her going, I see I just quit doing stuff. So this is all neutral. I'm not doing nothing. I'm monitoring her, sort of like an employee would. So I'm not doing her job for her or helping her do it, but I'm aware she's doing it. And I'm gonna go neutral and do nothing while she's right. If she starts, when she goes wrong, I'll step in and correct her. But then I leave her alone when she's right. And that's sort of a hard one for a lot of horse people to do, is the not moving part, you know, the quit doing something, okay? And so we practice a lot of these ones. You have to practice and teach. And this is very tough because like, say I said, you know, you get in the horse show and they're like, well, you know, they're judging you on if you're trotting, right? And so right when you feel your horse almost quit trotting, you would put the leg on, right? So you're squeezing when she's still in a trot, technically, correct? And so what we have to learn is a little bit different mindset, is you actually have to go, we're trying to teach this horse to know what you want and to do it well without all the micromanaging, right? So like right now, I want her to walk in a circle. If I want her to kick on, I won't do a dang thing until she quits that. And then right then, like if she starts to turn her head at me, I know that means she's gonna turn in again to me. So I can come out of neutral right then and reset her and then go back to nothing. But if this is the hard thing. So I'm a human, like they just wanna be like, oh, I'm like, you're not being judged. I wanna see her screw up. Mm-hmm. And so that I can see that right after she screws up, right then is when you come to life. So that the horse actually connects the dots to this. Because if I'm trying to teach her, her job is to maintain, there's two beginner things that she has to learn. Maintain the speed, maintain the direction. So this is the speed is the walk, direction is the right. And I will leave her alone, because that's what they want, as long as she's maintaining those basic concepts, okay? Now you see me tug on her halter every now and then because she's trying to go, so I have to get in there and be like, your speed's fine, but your direction's going funny, so I have to do something. But if she doesn't want me to do that pressure to her, she's going to start catching on and going, I need to keep my head over here, and then that pressure never happens to me, right? And I don't care right now if she wants to stop. Because I'm being very, very, like, the stuff I expect of her right now is very simple. Like, just barely doing it right, okay? So now if I want to quit it, now I'm going to go back into the shortened rope and I'm going to go, hey, that's one on your tail. Ah! So now I turn her around and she faced me again, but now she's afraid, she's a little worried to come back. So I'm going to go back to this because she's like, I don't know if I want to come to you. And that's totally normal because I just did weird stuff to her, right? So now I'm going to walk away from her and not go at her anymore. but still move this stick around and let her relax and not be like, well, that thing is coming at me all the time. Nope, it's now going away from you, so you can chill. Press her down.
Today, that was pretty good. That was a good first day.